It's time for the Family Feud. Introducing the Thompson family. Ed, Inez, Diane, Lois, and Bill, ready for action. And the Tooley family. Dean, Terry, Len, Ed, and Patty. On your marks, let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
It was the day before Christmas, and as you can see, the number one network is, of course, ABC. Yes. And the winning family, they have $1,228, the Thompson family. How are you, Ed? Congratulations, you're here, you're going to be challenged. Just remind me of all the nice people you've got with you.
I brought my wife, Inez, my daughter, Diane, my sister-in-law, Lois, and my son-in-law, Bill.
And you hand-picked Bill, I believe. Is that correct?
Yeah.
Now, this is a banker. Have you ever seen such a cheerful, happy fella? You are, right?
Where else could you get a job giving away money except yours?
That's
mine.
Right. We're both in a good business here. How are you, my darling?
Hi there, sweetie.
Everything well?
Just great.
No kiss today?
Mm-hmm.
I should think so. Look gorgeous. How's
Thank
everything?
You. Great.
You excited to be on
time.
TV?
You bet.
Yeah, sure. Little Diane.
Hi.
How you doing?
Just fine.
Going to speak louder? I'll have my producer over here.
Oh, sorry.
Speak up. Lois, my flower.
Richard. Oh, I love you. Guys.
She looked gorgeous.
Oh, thank you.
But you're a married lady, aren't
yes,
you?
Yes, I am.
I better move along.
Oh.
There's a guy in life insurance. How are you, Bill?
Fine, Richard.
You work out. You're very strong.
Periodically.
No, what do you do to keep fit?
Play a little handball, a little bit of tennis.
Yeah? I think he's a silent killer at heart. Nearly broke my hand. Here's a family going to challenge you called the Tooley. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Why, this is Dean. Dean. How are you?
Fine.
Who have you got with you, dog?
I have my son Terry, my son Len, my son Ed, and my daughter Patty.
What a lovely family.
I'm proud of them.
Well, you should be. I love your costume here.
Thank
it's
you,
very
sir.
Handsome.
Thank you.
What do you do, my darling?
Well, I am a housewife and mother. I'm a mother of seven. These are my four younger children.
Wow.
And my husband's a bus driver, one of the best RTDs.
Yeah? What's his name?
Harley Tooley.
Harley Tooley. Yes, what a nice mom.
She did.
What do you do, Terry?
I'm a probation officer.
Oh. I told you, Gene, they don't check. Gene has not been in to see you lately, right?
We're looking for him, yes.
Yeah, well, I'm glad you found him. How you doing, Len?
Fine.
What do you do?
I'm a student at Cal State LA.
Uh-huh, and you're on probation here with Eric. What are you studying?
Political science.
Good, nice to see you. Ed, how are you doing?
How you doing, Richard?
What's your story?
I'm a student at Valley College full-time, and I'm a part-time playground director at an elementary school.
Well, be that as it may, I'm moving on. I'm going to give Patty a kiss. Tell me a little about you.
I'm a cashier in a drugstore, and I just got a job as a teller in a bank. Not his bank, though.
No, not his bank? Well, you'll get together. I wish both families the best of luck. Let's play the bank. With the bank here. All right, now this is what we do. We surveyed 100 people. The top 8 answers are on the board. You have to try and find the most popular answer to this question. Name a gift mentioned in the song, The 12 Days of Christmas. Dean.
A partridge in a pear tree.
Yeah, a partridge in a pear tree. Come back here, darling. Partridge will never come up unless you're here to just take a look. Is there a partridge in town? Oh! My goodness me. That's the most popular answer. Now you have to decide whether you're going to play or you're going to pass.
Pass.
Don't let them intimidate you. Going to pass?
Four of them. We'll
pass. Go on back. Come on, they're going to pass to you, and we're going to see how it works out. Little Inez, name a gift mentioned in the song 12 Days of Christmas.
A dove?
A dove. Let's take a look. Is there a dove? Just laid an egg, I'm sorry to say, with that. That's your first strike. Two more strikes, you lose control of the question. Little old Tooley's have a chance to steal. Diane.
5 golden rings.
5 golden rings. Let's take a look. Is there 5 golden rings? That's 30. People said it. $6 or $7? Pardon? We should have given them. I thought there was a dove. Oh, we're going to give you a dove now. Just a second. Is there? There. We showed the spirit of Christmas, and they played an honest game here. All right, that's the 3 most popular answers. $86 there. No strikes on you. Lois, a gift mentioned in the song 12 Days of Christmas.
I want to say golden eggs.
Do you? Say it.
Golden eggs.
Good. We'll take a look and see if it worked out. She wanted to say golden eggs. Well, that's for the doves. That's your first strike. Bill.
French hens.
Pardon?
French hens.
French hens, of course. Hen francais. Oh, the blight must have gotten them. That's your second strike. Ed, I want a gift mentioned in the song 12 Days of Christmas. 5 answers remain. 3 seconds. You can do it right now. Talk it over.
Maids and milking.
Right. Yeah. I never had a gift like that. I wish I had. But if maids and milking is up there, I'll start drinking milk again. You all win the money that was built up by the Thompson family. If maids and milking's not there, the Thompsons get to keep it. Show us maids and milking. Now, stop frightening your mom. You yelled up in the air, her heart ticked over. Let's take a look and see the other gifts. Number 5. Number 6. Number 7. Number 8. Right, and a partridge with a trick knee. Right, you got $86. The first family to get $200 wins the game and plays for $5,000, and we will return. All right. The old French hens. No, it's the Tooleys. You have $86. And the French hens people named Thompsons have nothing. Inez, come on, my flower. Terry, come on. Let's go. I just want to warn you, if he happens to get the first one, he leaps in the air and yells. Poor Dean, his mom, nearly had cardiac arrest. But just play it very casually, okay? I'll put you on probation. Now, we surveyed 100 people. The top 5 answers are on the board to this question. Name something people do on Christmas Day. Terry.
They open presents.
They open presents. Show us presents.
Okay.
There's no way you can beat it, darling. That's the most popular answer. What are you going to do?
Play it. We're going to take it.
Going to play?
Yes, sir.
Going to play. Go on back there and we'll see how it works out. How do you ever discipline these kids?
I don't.
I didn't think you did. Glenn, name something people do on Christmas Day.
Sing carols.
Sing carols. What a sentimental old fool you are.
I love to sing.
Sure, so do I. Singing carols.
Okay.
All people said it. What's your favorite carol?
Silent Night.
Silent Night. Very nice. Ed, something people do on Christmas Day?
How about a Christmas dinner?
Yes. Good. We do on Christmas Day. A Christmas dinner. All right. It's as good as time to any to eat it. Certainly better than Easter, I know that. Well, take a look. Eat the Christmas dinner. Yeah. 93 people said it. $76, 2 answers remaining. Little Patty, name something people do on Christmas Day.
You visit relatives or neighbors.
Okay, sure. Visit. Let's take a look. Show us visit.
Oh, no.
That was banned last year. That's your first strike. 2 more strikes and you'll lose control of the question. And the Thompson family, and they're all over there plotting, hoping you strike out. will have a chance to steal. Dean, name something people do on Christmas Day.
How about have a drink?
Pardon?
Have a drink?
Well, I can't now, dear. I have a soda. But I certainly thank you for the...
invitation?
Yeah, now what's your answer?
Have a drink.
No, I can't. See, I have a soda. Oh, that's your answer.
Yeah.
Sure,
just for Christmas.
Right. That's a good idea. We'll take a look and see. Have a drink. That was also banned. That's your second strike. Okay. Terry, name something people do on Christmas Day. Two answers remaining.
I think they probably worship.
Pardon?
Worship? Go to church or worship.
All right. Show us worship. Okay. Yeah. One answer remaining, $81. Lynn, there are two strikes on you. A clean sweep or you'll give the Thompsons a chance to steal. Name something people do on Christmas Day.
What's Christmas without a tree? And so you want to decorate it. Decorate a Christmas tree.
Oh, really?
Right.
I would think that'd be a little late, but we'll take a look.
Well, I don't know.
Some people do it on Christmas morning.
I know they do.
Yeah.
Let's see if they were the ones we surveyed. Decorate a Christmas tree. Right now, you can do it. Talk
it
over.
Mistletoe.
Kiss under the mistletoe.
What do you say, Ed?
Get a kiss under the mistletoe.
No, I can't do that. Get a kiss under the mistletoe. We do that in our house. And if they've done it up here, you're going to steal that money and you'll be in the game if mistletoe's there. If it's not, the Tooleys get to keep it. Show us mistletoe. Yeah! I would have thought that would have been there. Yeah. You thought eggnog?
Yeah,
sip a little eggnog?
Yeah.
Let's take a look. Number three. They do indeed. And you're going to be able to give a party if things go. You've got $167. Thompson's on the eve of Christmas. Pull yourselves together. We'll take a commercial and we will return. Well, the Tooleys have $167, and just like the last time we played, you had nothing at all, and you had to make the comeback of the year. Thompson's nothing. Come on, Diane. Come on, Lane. That's how you did it the last time. Man of action here. Look. He's leaning already. Dollar values are doubled. That means you can get into the game here if you win it. You're the new champs, okay? We surveyed 100 people. Top four answers on the board to this question. Give me someone whose first or last name is Glenn. Diane.
John Glenn.
John Glenn. Show us John Glenn. 25 people. That's the astronaut, right? 25 people said it. We got $50. One answer even more popular, Lynn.
Glenn Ford.
Glenn Ford, a good actor. Let's see if he made the survey. Mr. Glenn Ford.
Yeah!
What are you going to do?
Well, play this one.
Yeah, I think Terry will kill you if you don't. All right, they're going to play, man. He's very violent. You're the probation officer, aren't you? You're
That's
supposed
you
to be full of compassion and tolerance. What happened to him? All the rest are so nice and quiet. Look at him. Hands
he's the
on
middle
his...
one of the family.
Oh, is he?
Yes. Three above and three below.
Rejected.
Ah. I don't think you rejected him.
Oh, no.
I would have, but
no
you
way.
Didn't. All right, there are only two answers remaining. $136 in that bank. Ed,
look,
I want someone whose first or last name is Glenn.
Glenn Abbott.
Glenn Abbott. Yeah. The Glenn Abbott. Well, I know there's so many, and I just want to make sure. Show us the one, the only, Glenn Abbott. Well, I am as shocked as you are. That I've known Glenn for, three or four minutes now, and, well, that's your first strike. Were you going to say Glenn Abbott?
No.
You've got that look as though he stole your answer. Little Patty, someone whose first or last name is Glenn.
Glenn Campbell?
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah. Hi, everybody. My name is Glenn Campbell. Let's take a look. Are you there, Glenn? Good job. Yes, indeed. Excuse me, just one second. I'm not going to mention this to anyone. Come on, it's just... Who's Glenn Abbott?
I don't know him either.
Do you not know a Glenn Abbott?
I know one. He's on probation.
Your name's just come to you.
Yeah.
Suddenly you think of a name.
Sleep.
No, I think it's marvelous. All right, we're going to take a look here now. We need dollar, 167 there, 184 there. One answer remaining, one strike. Give me someone whose first or last name is Glenn.
Glenn Douglas.
Glenn Douglas. Of course. So it's Glenn Douglas. That's your second strike. Terry, one more strike, you lose it. They'll get a chance to steal. Give me someone whose first or last name is Glenn.
Rudolph Glenn.
Rudolph Glenn. Show us Rudolph Glenn. Right now, you can do it.
Glenn Miller.
Glenn Miller.
Glenn Miller.
Glenn Miller.
Glenn Miller. Glenn, oh, Ed says Glenn Miller. Great orchestra leader. If he's there, you're in the game. If he's not, the Tooleys are the champs. Show us Glenn Miller. We'll be back right after this. Well, they've done it again. The Thompsons, 184. They're back in the game. 167 for the Tooleys. Ed, come on. Lois, let's do it. This question will decide the winning family. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed, the top three answers on the board to this question. Give me a word meaning you have no money. Lois.
Broke.
Broke? Show me broke. That's it. Gonna play, you're gonna pass. We're going to play. Ed, go on back and we'll see. Come on, Lois. Bill, give me a word meaning you have no money.
Busted.
Busted. Show us busted. Where are you? Six people said it right now. One answer remaining. Ed, you're a banker. You should know this. Give me a word meaning you have no money.
Bankrupt.
Bankrupt. Oh, yeah, that's very good. Show us bankrupt. Not there. That's your first strike. Inez.
Penniless.
Penniless, all right. Show me penniless. Not there. That's your second strike. Diane, give me a word meaning you have no money.
Poor.
Poor. Let's take a look. If poor is there, you'll remain the winning family. If not, they get a chance to steal. Show us poor. Well, Dean, my darling, you got $167. We have nice gifts for all of you. Thank you for being with us. We have nice prizes. Merry Christmas. Thank you for being with us. Take care. Bye, Patty. Thank you. That's it. Come on, who's going to play? Let's go. Both of you come out here. You're going to play first, little darling? We'll take a commercial, come back and see if they can win $5,000. Diane is here. Your dad's in a soundproof booth. We're going to play Fast Money. I ask you five questions. You give me five answers in 15 seconds. If you and your dad can get 200 points, we'll give you $5,000. Okay?
Okay.
All right. Give me 15 seconds on the clock, please. Time will start when I finish reading the first question. Besides a bird, name something found in a bird's cage.
A canary. Oh. A swing.
Say it.
A swing.
Something you wear boots to do.
Ski.
Something that has horns.
A reindeer.
A children's scout group.
Girl Scouts.
Something a doctor might put in your mouth.
A tongue depressor.
That's five. Good job. Turn around. Besides a bird, name something in a bird's cage. You said a swing. Our survey said 18. Something you wear boots to do, we asked. You said ski. Our survey said 12. You got 30. Something that has horns. You said reindeer. Our survey said 4. You have 34. A children's scout group. You said the Girl Scouts. Our survey said 22. You got 56. Something a doctor might put in your mouth. You said tongue depressor. Our survey said 54. Clear the door, please. Go on back. We're going to get your dad out here. All right. Come on, Ed. Stand right here. All you need is 90 points. I'll ask you the same questions I asked Diane. You cannot duplicate her answers. If you do, you hear this. I'll say try again, okay? Then give me another answer. Remind everyone, please, the answers Diane gave us, and then give me 20 seconds on the clock. Besides a bird, name something in a bird's cage.
Bird seat.
Something you wear boots to do.
Ski.
Try again.
Ice ski.
Something that has horns.
Deer.
Try again.
Goat.
Children's scout group.
Cub Scouts.
Something a doctor might put in your mouth.
Thermometer.
That's five. Turn around. You need 90 points. I said to you, besides a bird, name something in a bird's cage. You said bird seed. Our survey said 27. Number one answer, bird seed. 63 points away. Something you wear boots to do. You said ice skate. Our survey said zero. At least two people. Number one was hiking or horseback riding. Something that has horns. You said a goat. Our survey said 16. 47 away. A bull was the number one. Children's scout group. You said Cub Scouts. Our survey said 18 or 29. Boy Scouts was the number one. 29 points away. Something a doctor might put in your mouth. You said thermometer. Our survey said...
Some departing contestants receive a fragrance collection in ambush. The largest floral fragrance by Dana Ambush. One more interesting thing about you. And from Kenny Shoes, the great American shoe store. A beautiful selection of fashion and footwear. Kenny Shoes are with you every step of the way. And Presto's new Fry Baby electric deep fryer makes French frying easy and automatic. Inserting a two in a jiffy or two with Presto's Fry Baby. And an assortment of Red Devil paintbrushes and other fix-up cleanup products for your home. Big Red's a handyman to have around the house. This is Gene Wood speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production.